Hello, this is Thekla Petridou. Today it's Friday the 17th of January 2020, and today's video is about jealousy. I have received an email from a gentleman who wrote to me this: "Please, dear Thekla, may you talk about jealousy in the Shakespearean play entitled As You Like It. Oliver is jealous of his brother Orlando because he is of all sorts enchantingly beloved. In other words, people like him more than Oliver. Usually, people are jealous of another's property, wealth, and success. However, what about the more subtle ways in which jealousy manifests itself, such as not wanting someone to succeed, encouraging someone who is equally qualified as you to take a job which you would find demeaning, and trying to demean another's accomplishments? Also, encouraging someone not to follow their dreams or to find jobs which are outside of their profession, whilst you yourself, who are similarly qualified, wouldn't do so. Can you talk about the subtle ways in which jealousy manifests itself? Kind regards to you too, and thank you very much for bringing up this matter, because I think it's a very crucial matter in human relationships. You're right, there is overt jealousy and there is covert jealousy. You asked me to talk about subtle ways that people show their jealousy without it being so obvious. I have a slight different way of categorizing the feelings of jealousy. Is putting them in two big categories. The one is jealousy and the other is envy. Envy is when you do not like somebody to be successful, you do not like somebody to be happy, you do not like somebody to be in a good place in his or her life, and you try to sabotage them. When you are jealous, you might not be as bad a person as when you are envious, because jealousy can be positive. In which way? I am jealous that my friend has obtained a new job qualification, so I'm encouraged to achieve the same goal or a similar goal. Or I feel jealous because a friend of mine has gone holidays on a nice place and talks highly about this place, and I go there myself. This is not a bad thing. It's not a bad thing to try to achieve similar achievements as your friends or siblings or the other people in your environment have, because this kind of jealousy, it's innocent. It does not harm you. It does not harm you if somebody copies your lifestyle, or copies your haircut, or copies something that you do. If you are being on a pedestal from them, and they admire you and they want to look like you or be like you. Being envious, on the other hand, is the dark side of jealousy. It's when you do not like to see people happy and successful, and you do not like the achievements other people have achieved, and you want to sabotage them. This is not a subtle way of expressing jealousy. This is a brutal way of expressing jealousy, by being envious. And this way of behaving and this way of acting is clearly a toxic way. And you can feel the toxicity when you engage in any kind of relationships with people who are envious of you. You can feel it. You can feel the emotional negativity. You can feel yourself worn out after you hang around with them. you feel yourself feeling heavy on your chest when they make remarks on you, or when they make some comments which might on the surface look like good comments or caring comments, but underneath there is envy, and what they wish for you is not to be happy, not to be successful, and in a way they want to rob you of your well-being. So it is a fact, people have been jealous and envious over other people since the beginning of time. Even if you read on the Old Testament the first story about the two siblings who killed each other, you can understand, even if you see it in a symbolic manner, that being envious of other people and being jealous in a very hurtful manner has been innate in our nature as human beings. Of course, as civilization proceeds, as culture goes up, as human beings become better people, we expect that this kind of behaviors or this kind of attitude, being envious of other people and trying to sabotage other people's lives, will stop, will cease from happening. But this is not the case, because nowadays I believe, that's my personal belief, that people have become very materialistic, shall I say, or the rhythms of modern life, of our times, are so busy, and not so many people allow themselves the time and space to reflect on their actions, to reflect on their feelings, and to try to be spiritual beings and not only materialistic ones. Of course, there are spiritual people around us. Of course, there are people who, for example, watch this video, and they keep watching this video until now, which is the 7th minute and 22nd second. It's not that there is nobody around us who is loving and caring and genuine. You can find real human beings. You can find loving human beings and caring human beings only if you have the inner wish to do so, and if you have the courage and the strength to clear your life of these toxic people and toxic behaviors. If somebody makes you feel bad about yourself, if somebody demeans your accomplishments, treat you in a way that you feel not loved and not respected, you should have the guts to tell them off and kick them off your life, kick them out of your life. It's not easy to do so, because judging from my experience being a psychologist in Cyprus and Greece, and having worked with Mediterranean people for a long time, I think that we tend to be people pleasers, most of us, Greeks and Cypriots. But even, it doesn't mean, it's not only a thing that you find in Greek and Cypriot culture, but you can find it in other Eastern and Western cultures as well. The desire to be, to appeal as a good person to other people, the desire to please other people, not to be confrontational, and to be a good guy or a good girl. So it's a step of growth in our spiritual path to gain the power to say no. No, you cannot bother me anymore. No, I won't let you make me feel bad about myself. I do not take advice from people that envy me. I do not take advice from people that make me feel bad about myself. A real friend, a real loving person, will make you feel nice about yourself, will encourage you to do what's best for you. Even if they want to say something which is not so positive. For example, our friends might worry about us. We might have an addictive behavior, for example, and they worry about our well-being. They will find a way, a caring and loving person will find a way to talk to you in a manner that will make you feel well, not bad about yourself. Demeaning people is a tool, a toxic tool, which is used by envious people who want to make psychological warfare against you. I know that you are Greek in origin, and you read, and you are. I'm talking about the gentleman who sent the email to me in order to make this video. If you could read my book in Greek, which has the title Psychological Warfare, you will find a lot of encouragement in that book to understand how toxic people can manipulate people around them, how narcissistic personalities can attack on people who have low self-esteem, or who are people pleasers, or who have codependency issues and they cannot fight back. And the truth is that we need to fight back against these kind of behaviors, because they are not good for our health, not good for our emotional balance, not good for our well-being. So summarizing, jealousy is not necessarily a bad thing, but envy is a very hurtful thing, a very harmful feeling and course of action, and we want it out of our lives. Have a lovely weekend, everybody. See you next Friday, the same time on my channel. Bye.